to fight the unbeatable. Faith to remove the unmovable. Faith that stays the invisible. Faith that can conquer anything. Ooh, faith to reach the unreachable. Faith to fight the unmeetable. Faith to remove the unmovable. Faith that stands the invisible. Faith that can conquer anything.
Pray with me. God, thank you for the faith. Now help me preach and believe what I preach and live what I preach. And those with ears to hear through this virtual worship experience, increase our faith and trust in you. In Jesus' name we pray it all. Amen. Has anybody in Zoom land ever had a sleepless night where you tossed and turned and the silent sound seemed to scream out so loudly while the stresses from the day seemed to stick around in your mind and use your mind like a nightclub? And before you realize it, there's a party in your mind with the stresses from the day dancing around in your spirit, and you can't take it anymore. So you get up out of the bed and you turn on the TV just to have some real noise, to hear different sounds, to take your mind off the struggles and the troubles of the day. Then you find yourself channel surfing, and all you come across are these late night infomercials, folks trying to sell you just about anything and everything. And sometimes the products seem to be so unbelievably believable till you're tempted to pull out your purse to purchase while supplies last, because there's always a limited supply. You've seen it on TV and heard the testimonials, and that's enough for you to believe that it works. I don't know. Maybe there's somebody in Zoom land today who ain't ashamed to testify of the products that you purchased because you saw it on TV and believe the testimony. Now you can endorse the product too. Don't be ashamed if you purchase those HD Vision Special Ops glasses. I want me a pair of those when I see that guy standing by the mountainside. Or the Max Trainer Bowflex. Or if you've had the mattress wedge, can you testify that the mattress wedge helps you sleep at night? What about that tactical flashlight? That would be great when the electricity goes off during a tornado, or even while walking down the streets in Kansas City, Missouri at night. I don't know how many times in my head I have purchased the red copper 5-minute shift, as well as those Flex Seal items. I've sealed up a whole lot of stuff with that Flex Seal. Say amen to yourself if you got that pad egg so your feet could feel smooth, or even those Hercules hooks to hang up the pictures. But the one that always makes me laugh is the Doggy Dentures commercial with the Pedigree dental sticks. Don't be ashamed if you did that. And as a native Missourian, I know that sometimes you have to show folks better than you can tell folks. I know fully well that sometimes folks have to see things, tangible representations, before believing. Well, I've got a product for you today, and I'm convinced that it works. I've tried it for myself, and I've never stopped using it. In fact, the more you use it, the more it increases. I am a living testimony. This product is free, but you got to count the cost before using it. Not everybody is able to afford it. Not everybody is interested in its tried, tested, and true power. The price has already been paid on the Master's card, and no purchase necessary. You don't even need an Amazon Prime membership to purchase it, because it's already being delivered directly to your heart. COD, Christ on delivery, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Anybody ready for my tried, tested, and I know to be true product? If you are tired of trying to figure out how to make a dollar out of 15 cents, if you're tired of worrying about tomorrow, if you're tired of the struggles and the stress, if you're tired of the doubts and the fears, then you need to have faith in your life. Here's what faith is. It is still the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. This is how faith has traveled through the testimony since the beginning of time. By faith, we understand that the world was framed by the word of God. By faith, Noah built an ark when there was no cloud in the sky. Noah told me to tell you today that you can look crazy to the rest of the world, but that the ark that was built because he believed God said that it was going to rain. By faith, Abraham took his old self and relocated, left the comforts and successes, and believed God had an inheritance for him. Abraham told me to tell you today that he believed God will never send him where God had not already prepared for him. By faith, postmenopausal Sarah conceived, and because she believed God had promised her that she would have a child. By faith, Joshua took his weaponless army and marched around the walls of Jericho. Joshua told me to tell you, by faith, you better take yourself to the polls in November so God can break down the walls. By faith, Esther was able to stand up to her people in the midst of struggle and certain persecution and declare, if I perish, I perish. By faith, David defeated Goliath with a rock and a slingshot. David told me to remind somebody today that God can make your enemies your footstools. God's got your back. You are not in the battle by yourself. No weapon formed against you shall prosper, no matter what you're fighting today. By faith, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego was able to get out of the fiery furnace without a burn. They told me to tell you today that troubles don't last always. And when the heat is turned on, you won't get burned. So don't bow down or hang your hopes on the wrong person, place, or thing. By faith, in the midst of persecution, the prophets could declare what thus says the Lord. And Habakkuk wanted me to remind you today that the just shall live by faith. By faith, a peasant, unwed young woman gave birth to God and then had the nerve to say, my soul doth magnify the Lord. By faith, 12 outcast grungy men and one crazy woman followed one roughneck carpenter from Galilee who led by precept and example of what God's kingdom was all about, and even encouraged that if you have faith of a mustard seed, if you can believe God just a little bit, you can make it. As a matter of fact, you can even walk on water like Peter or have miracles manifested in your life. Just ask the Syrophoenician woman who had faith enough in Jesus to beg him to heal her daughter. Just ask the woman with the issue of blood for 12 years nonstop menstrual flow, and by faith with action touching the hem of Jesus' garment, and she was healed. What about the woman who was bent double over for 18 years, and by faith she believed Jesus' word, woman, thou art loosed. By faith, the man born blind put mud and spit on his eyes because Jesus told him to do it. And by faith, he could see clearly through spiritual eyes what the natural eye could never see. Amazing grace. gives you 2020 spiritual vision in the midst of a pandemic, a presidential election, a political pundits, or even pulpit pimps. You get visions to see, be able to see things differently. Not seeing the glass half empty, but half full. Taking life's lemons and making lemonade. Seeing the potential that even being broke as a joke, that you are blessed beyond measure. By faith in Jesus and action, a crippled man who complained of his situation for 38 years, how nobody would put him in the pool of Bethesda when the waters were stirred. And Jesus simply asked this question that I'll ask you today in Zoom land. Do you want to be made well? If you do, take up your own bed and walk. Beloved, some of us need to stop making excuses how somebody has done something to us when we are the ones who need to have faith enough to take up our beds and walk. By faith, Lazarus and Jairus' daughter were raised to life. Some of us need to be raised to life today to take the coffins off our backs to live so that God could use us to tell a dying world to look to Jesus. Look to Jesus now and live. If you have faith and your eyes stayed on Jesus, who led us by example, God's mandate for us to get along here on this island home called Earth with all of our diversity, complexities, various complexions, competencies, capacities, capabilities, created by the same God who loves us and loved the totality of the world so much that God gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in his teachings, believes in his ministry, believes in how he served others unconditionally, believes how he still is the Alpha and the Omega, our beginning and our ending, the author and finisher of our faith. Well, preacher, where can I get this faith? I'm so glad somebody in Zoom land asked the question. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Simply put, if you don't have faith, or if you're wavering in faith, you may need to change what you're listening to or who you're listening to. Stop listening to doubters and haters. Stop listening to folks who don't have a clue. If you want to have faith, hang out with people who have faith. Can I tell you a little secret? Facebook is not the faith book. Instagram will not sustain you. I'm just putting it out there just in case you got it twisted. The Apostle Paul reminds us as he writes to the church at Rome that righteousness comes by faith. He says, don't say in your heart who will go to heaven or who will go to hell. But what does it say? The word is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we proclaim. Because if you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For one believes with the heart and is so justified, and one confesses with the mouth and is so saved. The scripture says, no one who believes in him, hallelujah, will ever be put to shame. For there is no distinction between Jew and Greek. The same Lord is the Lord of all and is generous to all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. But how are they to call on the one whom they have not believed? And how are they to believe in one who they have never heard? And how do they hear without a preacher? And how do they preach, hallelujah, unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news, not garbage. Beloved, what does your feet look like? Well, I recognize and I realize not all have obeyed the good news. Isaiah said, Lord, who has believed our report? So faith comes by what is heard, and what is heard comes by the word of Christ. I feel like preaching today. Faith is is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Here's what faith can do. Faith helps you see the invisible. Faith allows you to accept the incredible. Faith encourages you to believe the impossible. Faith unlocks the door to countless possibilities in the kingdom of God. And for those who don't have faith, it's hard for them to understand what faith can do. If you want to have faith, you can. Just believe and receive it. God will manifest God's power in your life. Believe God. Here's what happens in your life when you have faith. Let me ask you this question. What more does God need to do for you to believe that God's got you? Just wait and have faith. Hope and believe that troubles won't last always. But I understand waiting can make you a little nervous. Waiting builds stamina. Waiting teaches patience. Waiting exposes our vulnerabilities because we realize that we are not in control. Learning, beloved, how to wait boosts our faith. But waiting can be nerve-wracking, especially if you've been waiting like I was waiting for a COVID-19 test result, waiting to hear from loved ones, waiting to get paid, waiting for church folks to understand this abstract concept of a concrete God. Waiting on the Lord can be challenging. David even saying these encouraging words, I would have lost heart unless I had believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord and be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I said, on the Lord. And even with the cataclysmic chaos and catastrophe befalling Job, he still had the nerve to declare, in all my appointed time, I'm going to wait till my change comes. Isaiah even had the audacity to write, because I guess he faced challenges of ungrateful folks, vacillating in faith kind of folks. Isaiah gives us comfort to God's people, and I share today, but those who wait on the Lord will renew their strength, and they will mount up like wings like eagles. We can exercise our faith. The longer that we exercise, the stronger that we will become. Beloved, when you get tired trying to intellectualize, rationalize, hypothesize, and even criticize your situation and circumstance, tired of drugs, racism, sexism, penny pinching instead of worshiping God who provides, when you get tired of gossip and despair, you'll begin to bow flex your faith muscle, and God will give you the strength and the courage to faith your way through. But there will be times where you become weary and discouraged, but faith will help you through the storms of life. Faith will help you through the chilly, strong winds. Faith will help you overcome negativity. Faith will help you through sorrow and pain. Faith will help you through Donald Trump's administration. We can have faith based on our abilities to handle. It was by faith one Friday afternoon that Jesus walked, didn't grow weary as he bore the cross after being poked on the side to carry away our sins. Thank God and hallelujah, on that third day, he stretched out in faith to help get out of the grave so that we can have faith to know that we can overcome too. So the next time troubles is all around you and you think you can't get through, exercise your faith. The next time you're in the depths of despair, exercise your faith. The next time you're in a funk of failure, exercise your faith. The next time somebody talks about you, you better bow flex your faith your way through. The next time you're penniless, stretch out your faith. The next time you're sick, faith your way through and watch what faith can do for you. We have come this far by faith, leaning on the Lord, trusting in his holy word. Guess what? God has never failed us yet. We can't turn around, beloved. You can't fall apart, and you better not be discouraged. Will you declare with me today, in the sanctuary of your heart, declare with me today that my faith looks up to the